exactly right. The competition is going to come in many different forms for lawyers in the future. I don't think there's much that we can do about it. It's going to happen. And the question is, how can young lawyers or more senior lawyers prepare for this? And it seems to me that we can't deliver our services in the same ways that we always have. We need to adapt, we need to evolve, we need to embrace technology and innovation, and think about how we can compete with these new providers and deliver services that the public needs at a price that is competitive with all of these services. I think that is the challenge that we face as a profession. I think we can meet that challenge, but it's really important that we understand the tools and the knowledge that's going to be required in order to compete in the 21st century legal marketplace. So as a dean of a law school, it's teaching those kinds of skills and that kind of knowledge that I think is going to be really important for the future of lawyers, both in the United States and Chile and everywhere else in the world. Currently in law school, we teach what we call issue spotting. Mm-hmm. The idea is you study bodies, areas of law, so that when you encounter them in practice, you remember that you have seen that area of law before and you have some sense of where to look to find the answer to a specific question. What I think we need to do with law students is teach issue spotting, but of a different kind, technology issue spotting, so that they learn what technology is capable of doing to deliver services more rapidly, like automated legal document assembly. So how do you create a legal document in a more efficient, automated way that requires less time working on very routine tasks? I want students to be exposed to that kind of technology so that when they are in practice, in a law firm, in a company, when they see a particular service being provided, they remember from law school the concepts that will allow them to deliver that service in a new, different, and better way, a better, faster, and cheaper way of delivering that service that will make that student, that lawyer, more valuable and more competitive in the future if they understand those concepts. So we're doing a few different things. We have created a set of courses for our current JD students, our current law students, in areas such as legal project management and process improvement, how to use automated document assembly. And we've also created coding in the law and a number of different courses that didn't exist 5 or 10 years ago. But in addition to that, we're giving our students opportunities to apply what they've learned in the classroom in real world settings. So for example, we've created a new kind of clinic called the Legal Innovation and Technology Lab. And the idea behind the lab is that instead of representing an individual client, we will represent a court, a legal aid agency, a government agency, and help them reimagine the way they deliver their services. So the students are using what they've learned in the classroom and then helping an organization rethink their work and allow them to deliver their services more effectively and efficiently. So we're giving those kinds of experiences to our students. But then in addition, we've also created an online certificate program that we've made available to the world because it's entirely online. We've taken the courses that we've developed and made them available that way. So for example, legal project management and process improvement, an overview course of 21st century legal practice, a course on legal operations inside of corporate legal departments, just as a few examples. And we've been delighted to see that people from all around the world have actually signed up to take classes in that certificate program.